These videos tend to make waves, so there's probably going to be some arguments in the comments. With a new COD game right around the corner, I think it's time we revive an age-old topic. What COD multiplayer is the best? Today, I'm going to bring you guys my personal picks for the 10 best Call of Duty multiplayers of all time. Now, this is going to be in order from worst to best. What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Welcome to the channel. Welcome to the video. I need you to keep in mind, there have been more than 10 multiplayers, so there's going to be a few that don't even make the list, and if they don't make the list, well, you can guess where I rank them. I know, some of you are going to get very salty in the comment section. You let me know what your top 10 list for COD multiplayers is. Drop a like, and guys, I now have a support a creator code for Call of Duty. Simply code CHAOS. If you use it in the Modern Warfare store for anything Modern Warfare or Warzone, your boy gets a small portion of that. I want to say big shout out to Call of Duty for picking me, honestly, for picking me, and a big shout out to you guys for giving me the opportunity to get to this point. You can see on the screen right now, these are people that have used code CHAOS. If you use it, make sure to show me on Twitter. Shoot me a picture, and you could end up in a future video. Now, here we go. Worst to best. My personal picks now, so don't get too angry. At number 10, Call of Duty Ghost. I know, hold on. It launched in 2013, and at that time, it was a confusing game. Not only did it launch on the Xbox 360 and the PS3, it also launched on the One and the PS4, but it also changed up a lot of stuff that we held near and dear to our hearts. The time to kill was cranked up, the pace was slowed down, the maps were gigantic, and Infinity Ward seemed to be trying to make COD into something more tactical. Now, a lot of people hated COD Ghost because it was so different, and I understand that, but at the same time, Ghost had this special charm to it. The slower pace and the bigger map design made objective modes like Search and Destroy super fun, especially to watch. In fact, many people still think Ghost has the best S&D in the entire franchise. That's a video for another day. Plus, in order to compensate for the slower game pace, IW went all out with their party modes. Gun Game, Infected, they gave us the best DLC map selection of any COD game to date. So, Ghost was hated for its core gameplay, yes. But everything around the core gameplay was pretty good. And that's where we're going to start. At number 9. Advanced Warfare. Speaking of games that changed up the formula. Now, AW was a controversial game, we all know that. The game structure was very traditional for Call of Duty, but they added jetpacks, which dramatically changed the way it played out. Advanced Warfare was fast, frantic, dynamic, and honestly, it wasn't that bad. Going back and playing AW now isn't very fun because the movement is super, super clunky, but for its time, it was fresh and exciting at the time. I know, the maps weren't anything special to write home about, but the moment-to-moment gameplay, it was fun. Plus, this was the game that introduced Uplink, which is one of the most underrated game modes in COD history. One of the most fun spectator modes to watch. I didn't mind Advanced Warfare. I actually don't think it aged very well, but you can enjoy it for what it is. Next up is going to shock a lot of you if you follow me. I'm trying to be true to myself here. COD World War II post-overhaul. Let me make it very clear. Well, I've made it very clear that COD World War II wasn't a good game on launch day, and it stayed that way for months. But once the big overhaul came, well, it was a solid game. I hated how much customization was removed in the first version of COD World War II and how limiting the game was overall. And that's not even getting into all the bugs and connection issues. After the big sledgehammer shakeup, though, the game was reworked entirely. It's actually in a good state now. The maps are average, and there's still some obvious issues, but it's far, far, far from where it was. And as for boots on the ground COD games go, it's not bad. Do I think it's better than World at War? Absolutely not. Do I think it's as good as the Golden Age COD games? Absolutely not. But do I think it was better than Black Ops 4 and Modern Warfare 2019? Post-overhaul? Yeah, possibly. At number 7, Modern Warfare 2. Now, this may be a bit of a hot take, but it's not one of my favorites. I know a lot of my colleagues and peers loved it. I loved it too, mind you, okay? You when you rank these, there's only so many spots. I think it was great, but I don't think it's a top 5. I just don't, not like a lot of the other older players. Modern Warfare 2 had some of the best maps and killstreaks in COD history, and the weapon balance was excellent because just about every weapon was viable in one way or another. For me, Modern Warfare 2 just didn't grab me as much because it was more about explosives and killstreaks rather than just pure gunfights, and there's nothing wrong with that. It's just a different style of gameplay. I've always been more interested in COD games that are more about pure aim versus aim and guns versus guns rather than relying on explosives and killstreaks. Again, I loved Modern Warfare 2, and I know some people are going to be super pissed at me for putting this at number 7, but it was just a very different kind of COD game, and while I did love it, I think the rest on this list coming up are better. At number 6, COD 4. Now, I know this one's going to piss people off, but I preferred COD 4 to Modern Warfare 2. COD 4 was a very simple game, but it was unique. It took the foundation of COD 2. It added things like sprinting, custom classes, killstreaks, more fast-paced game, most stuff we don't even think about now. But back then, it was groundbreaking. The map design is also some of the best in COD history. It found that perfect middle ground between cluttered and organized. It embraced the three-lane layout, but still made every map feel unique in its own way. It did. Other CODs have tried to do that, and they fail. Now, COD games are either way too married to the three-lane design, like World War II and Black Ops 4, or they go too far in the opposite direction and make maps feel cluttered and unorganized, like Modern Warfare 2019. But COD 4, they found that middle ground. It was complemented with great gun, simple killstreaks, and awesome sound design. I love COD 4, and I know it's a hot take to say I liked it more than Modern Warfare 2, but there you go. It's my list, my video. At number 5, Black Ops 3. Now, at this point, I know there are going to be some of you who are absolutely livid with me, but I'm being honest. I liked Black Ops 3. Of all the COD games to come out on the PS4, Black Ops 3 is by far the one I played the most. The game just did a lot right. The gun balance was solid for the most part. The maps were good for the most part. The movement was super smooth and the gunplay did feel good. The streaks, they were pretty rewarding but not too strong, and the game overall just felt like a really good progression from Advanced Warfare, like Treyarch took the foundation of AW and improved upon all the little details to make it the best. I mean, it was the best jetpack COD game, it was. I do admit that the tone was a little all over the place and the supply drops were very predatory, but for what it was, Black Ops 3 was good. In all the 8th gen COD games, I think it was my favorite. At number 4, and this is going to shock a lot of you, Modern Warfare 3. This is one of those games that was widely hated on launch day, but as time went on, it was like a fine wine. People started to appreciate it. Due to it being rushed through development, it had a ton of animations and weapon models from Modern Warfare 2, and it featured an almost identical art style, which led to a lot of the community calling it Modern Warfare 2.5. But when you get into the actual gameplay, the gunplay, it changed a lot. Stopping power was removed, the time to kill was increased, explosives were nerfed to make the game more about gunfights, and the killstreak system was divided into 3 strike packages, the Assault, Support, and Specialist. Plus, MW3 had the most launch content of any COD game ever. 50 guns, 16 maps, 24 game modes. And IW was constantly updating the playlist with new ones they got from community feedback. Modern Warfare 3 was a fun game, and for content on YouTube, it was true golden age. I loved it. In terms of objective quality and game design, I think it's the weakest of the Modern Warfare trilogy, but in terms of the pure fun factor, I think it's the best. You guys can debate. At number 3, World at War. Now, there's probably going to be a few of you sharpening pitchforks at this point listening to me talk, but hey, you clicked the video and you made it this far. World at War launched in 2008, and Activision basically wanted Treyarch to just make a World War II reskin of COD 4, but guess what? I liked COD 4, so I was okay with that. But that's not to say World at War plays exactly like COD 4, because it doesn't. It plays out entirely different, actually, despite sharing a lot of the same framework. The maps are more open, the weapons are slower, there's more precision-based, and there's less reliance on explosives and equipment. The game overall just feels more raw, gritty, and dark. Plus, World at War's map design gave it an entirely unique personality, and who can forget War Mode, the true War Mode. WoW was a great example of how to take the framework of another game and make it feel completely unique. Only 2 left, guys. At number 2, this is going to shock people because I know I've been on record saying this was my favorite. Overall, it is. But multiplayer, I'm going to go with Black Ops. I talk about this game all the time. You probably expected it at number 1. We're just talking about multiplayer, so it's number 2. If we were talking about campaigns or overall package, it is number 1. But multiplayer, number 2. Now, that being said, I adored the game. Black Ops 1 played like a slightly slowed down version of MW2, and I loved it. The map design was a bit simpler, it was more straightforward, which encouraged constant action and engagement. Now, annoying things like Commando Pro and One Man Army, they were gone, in favor for a more detailed attachment system that let you get really elaborate with your weapon. Sure, the weapon balance wasn't all that great, but there was a lot of fan favorites. The FAMAS, the Galil, the M16, the Commando, the AK-74U, the Python, I can go on. It wasn't a perfect game, but it was definitely one of the best offerings of the Golden Age, beaten out by only one other multiplayer. Now, you have to know what's at number 1, because if I didn't put this at number 1, you're going to be looking at me like, are you kidding me? Black Ops 2. All the hot takes that I've dropped in this video, this should be a good, uncontroversial one to end it off. BO2 launched in 2012, and many COD players consider it the best. It changed tons of elements in the COD formula, but all of them were for the better. They changed killstreaks to scorestreaks. They reworked the camo system into what we know today. They made streaks faster in order to keep the focus on the actual gunplay. They even lengthened the time to kill ever so slightly to make it more skill-based. They gave us our first taste of rank mode in COD, and it was perfect. We never got it back. And they gave us a dedicated party mode playlist. There was so much content in Black Ops 2, and it was great. Sure, a few of the maps were stinkers, but, I mean, we had legacy maps, man. Hijacked, Raid, Standoff, Slums, and, yeah, Nukedown. It wasn't the first time. Black Ops 2, it was good. It had banger DLC, studio, uplink, grind. I could go on and on and on. For a multiplayer experience in Call of Duty, I am confident saying this is my favorite of all time. You guys rank them down below. Let me know where you agree and disagree. I'm sure a lot of you are going to disagree, but that's the fun of it. I hope you guys have a great day, and I'll see you soon.